Hey guys, I have with me here today the artificial insemination reusable gun, or probe if you will. So we're just going to go over an overview of the functions and features of the probe, kind of demonstrate some of the setup, use, and what exactly you're looking at when it comes to the device. So first I'll take it out and remove it from its case. So when you first receive it, this silicone durable cover, which you don't need to use, but it does help protect the device. You'll need to put this over the top. There's also a layer of film that protects the screen. If you just pick at it on the side and peel it off, if you see anything that looks like scratches, it's just due to that screen cover. It's actually a protective film that you can simply remove. So I've already removed mine here, but we're gonna go ahead and show you the rest of the buttons, and I'm just gonna remove the cover. So the device is rechargeable. Here you have a micro USB port there. You also have another power plug there. On the side, you have a micro SD card slot, which you can use to export out the images and videos that you take. The micro SD will come with your kit. Okay, so next we have our power button on the far right. All you need to do to power it on, it is a rechargeable battery inside. Just hold the button down about 2 seconds until the screen pops up. You'll then begin to see the image on the screen. Looking out at the surroundings. We have a number of different buttons on the top that accomplish different things. So this button here is actually gonna allow you to take an image, and you'll see that icon pop up of what you're looking at. The far left button will show you the image and video reel, or what you have saved to the SD card. So if you push that, you can look at your most recently captured image. If you push that again, you return just to regular view mode. The button right in the center records a video. So while you're in there, if you prefer to take a video rather than a picture to record it for any reason, you can push this button and push again to stop. You'll see the second countdown on the top indicating that the video is live and rolling. And then go back into our playback and review if that video is there. And lastly, the second button from the top here, second button from the left, is where you can change any settings. I recommend leaving the settings as is. However, let's go further into the hardware of the device. So up front here, we have the aperture where the disposable tube is inserted for the injection of the semen. Next, you have your handle for which to grab it from, your air pump button, which is this right here. You can hear it go on when I push it. I'll get further into what that does here in a minute. Your 12.5 inch stainless steel probe with the hollow inside for which to put through the disposable tubing. You have your LED illumination light. On the inside of that is your camera. On that bottom side right here is the aperture that your disposable tubing goes through. And on the far side up top here is where your air pump pushes air through at a 90 degree angle to the surface of your screen. So the air pump is intended to remove phlegm, liquid, and other buildup from the camera as you're inserted. However, it usually is best to try to avoid accumulating phlegm or mucus on the camera to begin with. In many cases, you will have to remove the AI probe to clean that off using a Q-tip, as the air pump isn't always sufficient to remove it. So let me show you next what comes with your kit, your disposable tubes. You may also be wondering what the steel probes are that you get that come with it. So one of these is essentially a stylet or a cleaning device. If you get anything lodged into the stainless steel, now with using the disposable tubes, you will not have this issue. But if anything does lodge in there, you can insert it and dislodge the debris. The next one is a stainless steel insemination tube. So you insert it like that. I don't really recommend using the stainless steel insemination tube. Again, with the metal, it is easier to puncture her while you're on the inside performing the insemination. We do recommend using the soft plastic disposable tubing. However, this is included in your kit should you decide to use it. In this case, it would basically perform the same function that you attach the semen through. push it through the tube, it will come out on the tip at the end. However, with the disposable tubing, it's pretty much the same function. We'll remove one of our single-use tubes here, which make it very easy for cleaning and a quick process. You can see on the tube, there are holes on the side, so the semen will come through out on the side. The tube is just slightly longer than the full length of the probe. See it come out the end there. So you don't necessarily need to stick it all the way through. You can retract it back, depending on exactly where you want to deposit the semen. If you have it too close, you may deposit some semen on the camera and the probe and lose visibility. If you have it too far, you may poke into her and tickle her during the procedure. So just position it exactly where you think is the best fit. And it'll be the same thing here, where you insert the syringe. Of course, this procedure is probably best done with two people. You can also use a lure lock. All plastic syringes will lock to the outside rather than going through the inside. However, the ones we include do fit right through the inside of the end of the wing cap of your tube. You can then push the semen through, like so, and remove once complete. That's basically the overview of the mechanisms and the functions of the AI probe. Thank you for coming and visiting us here today at KNIP4, and we'll talk to you next time.